Myself, Dr. Ishrat Sheikh from Abidai Inamdar Senior College, Pune, is going to present first lecture on sericulture. Content of today's lecture is an introduction to sericulture, study of different types of silk moths, their distribution, taxonomic position, and varieties of silk produced in India. We will be studying mulberry, tussar, avi, and muga silk moths. Now, introduction to sericulture. Sericus in Greek means silk and culture in English means rearing. Therefore, sericulture is rearing of silk moth. Sericulture is a labor-intensive, rural, agro-based, export-oriented, welfare-oriented cottage industry. This is because for rearing of silkworm, for cultivation of mulberry, for harvesting of mulberry, you need manpower. Therefore, it is labor intensive. It is based on agriculture because mulberry cultivation is agro-based. Therefore, sericulture is an agro-based industry. It is export-oriented. Silk is a very costly fiber and it has great demand in market all over the world. Therefore, it is export-oriented. It is welfare-oriented because the rural mass, they get employment and it is for their betterment, for their upliftment. 95% of the commercial silk that we get is from the insect mulberry silkworm, that is Bombyx mori, and it is mulberry silk. So 95% of silk, insect silk you get is mulberry silk. Remaining 5% of the silk is non-mulberry silk, and it includes tussar, eri, muga, anafe, gonomta, fagara silk, spider silk, and mussel silk. Mussel silk is by the byssus fiber of the mussel. Now, definition of sericulture. The art of rearing silkworms under artificial conditions for the production of raw silk, extraction of the silk fiber from their cocoon, reeling, twisting, weaving, and it is capable of providing remunerative employment to the rural, unemployed youngsters and women. Okay, so here we go for artificial rearing in sericulture usually. Now, origin of silk. Silk originated in China about 3000 BC ago. A Chinese princess, Ling Shi XI, discovered the art of reeling an unbroken silk filament. It so happened that a mulberry cocoon fell into a hot bowl of tea. And when she started removing the cocoon, a fine lustrous filament came out, and that is how the origin of silk is there. Now, silk being a costly and beautiful natural fiber of great value was worn by the Chinese royals. Later on, the art of rearing along with the eggs and pupa was smuggled out of China by monks and by other people, prisoners of war, etc. Now, why sericulture is a profitable business? Why it's good for the rural youth? Why it is good for the farmers? Because sericulture can be practiced with a small amount of initial investment. You need very small space. It gives very quick return within 30 days. All the rural mass can be employed in this. They need not migrate to the city for jobs. It is a side business to the farmer. Along with his regular agricultural work, he or she can pursue sericulture also. It can be practiced all over India. Major states that practice sericulture are Karnataka, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Jammu, Kashmir, Gujarat, Kerala, Maharashtra, UP, Bihar, Rajasthan, Orissa, and most of the northeastern states also. So it covers almost all of India. Now, position of India, if you see the world ranking, then China ranks first in the world in overall silk production, producing around 71,845 metric tons of silk. India ranks second in world with 13,913 metric tons. Then India is first in the world in the production of golden silk, that is Muga silk, because it is found only in Assam. It is second in the production of Tassar silk and fifth in the production of mulberry silk in the world. Now, taxonomic position of the major four silkworms, all in one: phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, superfamily is Bombycoidea. There are two families, Bombycidae and Saturnidae. From Bombycidae we have Bombyx mori, and from Saturnidae we have two genus, Antheraia and Philosemia. From Antheraia we are having two species, Assamensis and Mylita, and in Philosemia species is Ricin. Next point is types of silk moths, their distribution and varieties of silk produced. All four types of economically important silkworms are reared in India. Mulberry silkworm, that is Bombyx mori, Tassar silkworm, that is Antheria mylita, Airy silkworm, Philosemia ricini, and Philosemia cynthia, then Muga silkworm, Antheria assamensis. Now let us study the first one, that is mulberry silkworm or Bombyx mori. Mulberry silkworm feeds on mulberry leaves. The classification of mulberry silkworm is based on the following four parameters. First is geographical distribution, in which place they are found, whether India, China, Japan. In this way, their names are different. Number of generations produced in a year, univoltine, bivoltine, multivoltine. Number of molts during the larval growth, trimolter, tetramolter, pentamolters, pure or hybrid, monohybrid, polyhybrid. This is the larvae of Bombyx mori. This is the adult with bipectinate antenna, large abdomen, whole body is white in color. Now, distribution of mulberry silkworm. Mulberry silkworm is found in 59 countries of the world. Major six countries which produce mulberry silk are China, India, Japan, Russia, Brazil, and Korea. They together produce 96.9% of world's mulberry silk. Five major mulberry silk producing states of India are Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Jammu and Kashmir. These produce 92% of the country's total raw mulberry silk. Taxonomic position of mulberry silkworm: phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, belonging to superfamily Bombycoidea and family Bombycidae. Genus and species are Bombyx mori. Now, variety of silk produced by mulberry silkworm. Mulberry silk is supposed to be superior quality compared to other silk. It's lustrous and shining with creamy white or yellow color. It's more refined, uniform in color and texture. The clothes made from 100% mulberry silk is durable and is a luxury. It's natural, odorless fiber and does not cause allergy. The second silkworm is Tassar silkworm, Antheria mylita. We have two types. So Indian temperate Tassar silkworms are Antheraia proili. It is a univoltine or bivoltine species and is polyphagous. Its main food is oak leaves, but it feeds on other allied species also. Then we have the Indian tropical Tassar silkworm, Antheria mylita. It is multivoltine and polyphagous. It feeds mainly on the leaves of Arjuna, that is Terminalia, but it also feeds on two dozen of its related species such as Sal, Sida, Bear, etc. Adult of Tassar silk moth, if you see, the females are larger and yellowish brown, while males are smaller and red in color. Now, distribution of tussar silkworm in India. Tussar silk tropical variety you will find all along the tropical belt. It extends from West Bengal to Karnataka. That whole batch covering Bihar, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and Maharashtra. Rearing as well as collection from forests is popular in the states of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Maharashtra, West Bengal, and Andhra Pradesh. Tussar silk produced by the temperate variety, that is Froyle type, is found from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, all along the Himalayan belt. Taxonomic position of tussar silkworm. Again, we have phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order is Lepidoptera, superfamily Bombycoidae, family Saturnidae, genus is Antheria, and species we have the tropical variety Mylitta and the temperate variety Froyle. Variety of silk produced by tussar silkworm. Tussar silk is coppery color, coarse silk, mainly used for furnishings and interiors. It is less lustrous than mulberry silk, but it has its own unique feel and appeal. Cocoon collection is one of the important means of livelihood for the tribals, as they collect it from forests, basically for silk, as well as the protein-rich pupa is a delicacy. Oak tussar is of finer quality and is produced in the Himalayan belt. It is the temperate variety. The tussar is produced by Antheria Froyle. Now the third one is Airy silkworm, Philosemia ricini. Type is Philosemia cynthia is a bivoltine wild variety which you find only in the wild. Tribals collect it from wild. The pupa, the cocoons are collected from wild. Whereas Philosemia ricini is reared on castor plants, leaves, that is Ricinus communis. Philosemia ricini is a polyphagous variety and it feeds on kesaru, tapioca, and bar kesaru. It is multivoltine and it has 5 to 6 generations in a year. Distribution of Airy silkworm. In India, Airy silkworm culture is practiced mainly in the northeastern states of Brahmaputra Valley and Assam. Airy culture or culture of Airy silkworm is a household activity. It is practiced mainly for the protein-rich pupa, which is a delicacy for the tribals, while silk is used in the preparation of chadars and wraps. Out of 130,000 kg silk produced in India, Assam alone produces 106,000 kg. In addition, it is also found in Bihar, West Bengal, and Orissa. Taxonomic position of Airy silkworm belongs to phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order is Lepidoptera, superfamily Bombycoidae, family Saturnidae, genus Philosemia, and species Ricini, which is domesticated one, and Cynthia, which is wild one. The cocoon produced by Airy silkworm is loose and white in color. Silk produced is again white in color but less shining as compared to mulberry silk. Texture is coarse, fine, and dense. It blends well with wool, has thermal properties, hence it is used in making winter wears. Being strong and durable, it is used in making home furnishings. Its silk is spun as it cannot be reeled. Therefore, pupa are not killed and other adult moths are allowed to emerge from their cocoons. Usually, if you see in case of mulberry silkworm or tussar silk or muga silk, what is done is stifling process is done to kill the pupa inside so that adults will not come, because if adults come out then they will pierce the cocoon and you will not get a continuous silk fiber. But here in this case you will find ki as you are not able to reel it, therefore there is no need to kill the pupa and adults are allowed to come out. Therefore, such type of silk is called as Ahimsa silk and it is popular among vegans and Buddhist monks. So this is the adult Aedes silk moth, male and female. Larva of Aedes silk moth, white in color. Then the fourth one is Muga silkworm, Antheria asamensis. The Muga silkworms are multivoltine and semi-domesticated type. Usually indoor rearing is done. Host plant is Soam and Salu. So Antheria asamensis feeds on the aromatic leaves of Soam and Salu, which are evergreen trees. This silk worm is specific to Assam and Pride of India. It is found only in India and in Assam. It is found in the Brahmaputra Valley and hills of Assam. 94% of Muga silk is produced in Assam and nearly that much is consumed in Assam itself, leaving only 5 to 6% for the remaining country. This is because there is a tradition that the brides, they have to spin their own dress of Muga silk for their wedding. Therefore, maximum is consumed in Assam itself. Taxonomic position of Muga silkworm: phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, superfamily Bombycoidea, family Saturnidae, genus Antheria, and species Assamensis. The variety of silk produced by Muga silk is very exceptional. The cocoons are amber or golden and they produce glazing golden yellow attractive and strong silk. Very beautiful golden silk is produced by Muga silkworm. Durability is more than the lifetime of human beings. And as time progresses, with the increase in time, the luster of the silk also increases. This is very rare silk and is pride of Assam. It is registered as geographical indication of Assam. It is used in products like making of saris, mekhalas, chadars, etc. So this is the larvae of Muga silkworm. This is the adult moth. Thank you.